गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ जीके। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट आवर न्यू लेसन, लेसन नंबर 31, ज्योग्राफी क्विज। नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन। टेक द राइट आंसर। पावरफुल फोर्सेस प्रोड्यूस बाय मूवमेंट्स अलॉन्ग फॉल्ट्स इन साइड द अर्थ इज नोन एज ऑप्शन ए वोल्केनोज, ऑप्शन बी अर्थक्वेक्स। आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी अर्थक्वेक्स। एन अर्थक्वेक इज द सडन मूवमेंट ऑफ द अर्थ टेक्टोनिक प्लेट्स रिजल्टिंग इन शेकिंग ऑफ द ग्राउंड। दिस शेकिंग कैन रिजल्ट इन द डैमेज ऑफ वेरियस स्ट्रक्चर्स सच एज बिल्डिंग्स एंड फर्दर ब्रेक डाउन ऑफ अर्थ सर्फेस। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन। अ वेदर पैटर्न ओवर अ रीजन फॉर अ लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ टाइम इज नोन एज ऑप्शन ए क्लाइमेट, ऑप्शन बी टेम्परेचर। आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए क्लाइमेट। क्लाइमेट मीन्स द यूजुअल कंडीशन ऑफ द टेम्परेचर, ह्यूमिडिटी, एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर, विंड, रेनफॉल एंड अदर मीटरोलॉजिकल एलिमेंट्स इन एरिया ऑफ अ सरफेस फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम। इन सिंपल टर्म्स क्लाइमेट इज द एवरेज कंडीशन फॉर अबाउट 30 ईयर्स। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन। थिंग्स इन नेचर पीपल यूज टू मीट देयर नीड्स इज नोन एज ऑप्शन ए नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज, ऑप्शन बी फॉसिल फ्यूल। आंसर इज ऑप्शन ए नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज। नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज आर मटेरियल्स फ्रॉम द अर्थ दैट आर यूज टू सपोर्ट लाइफ एंड मीट पीपल्स नीड्स। Any natural substance that humans can be used considered a natural resource. Oil, coal, natural gas, metals, stone and sand are natural resources. Other natural resources are air, sunlight, soil and water. Next question. The imaginary line that divides the earth in two hemispheres, Northern and Southern, is known as option A Tropic of Cancer, option B Equator. Answer is option B Equator. The equator or line of 0 degrees latitude divides the earth into northern and southern hemispheres. The northern hemisphere contains North America, the northern part of South America, Europe, and the northern two-thirds of Africa and most of Asia. The southern hemisphere contains most of South America, one-third of Africa, Australia, Antarctica, and some Asian islands. Next question. Imaginary lines that circle the earth in east-west direction is known as option A longitude, option B latitudes, answer option B latitudes. The imaginary lines circling the globe in a east-west direction are called the lines of latitude. They are used to measure distances north and south of the equator. Next question. Movement of people from rural areas to urban areas is known as option A urbanization and option B migration. Answer is option A urbanization. Urbanization refers to the population shift from rural to urban areas. The decrease in the proportion of people living in rural areas and the ways in which societies adapt to this change. It is predominantly the process by which towns and cities are formed and become larger as more people begin living and working in central areas. Next question. The movement of water from ocean to air, then to the land and back to the ocean is known as option A water cycle, option B evaporation. Answer is option A water cycle. The water or hydrology cycle describes the pilgrimage of water as water molecules make their way from Earth's surface to the atmosphere and back again, in some cases to below the surface. This gigantic system, powered by energy from the sun, is a continuous exchange of moisture between the ocean, the atmosphere, and the land. Next question. The sun is made up of dash. Option A, magma. Option B, gases. Answer is option B, gases. The sun is yellow dwarf star, a hot ball of glowing gases at the heart of our solar system. The sun, like other stars, is a ball of gas. In terms of the number of atoms, it is made of 91% hydrogen and 8.9% helium. By mass, the sun is about 70.6% hydrogen and 27.4% helium. Fun fact, Cotopaxi is the highest active volcano. Now students, we will start our next chapter, chapter number 32, our defense forces. Let us start question answer session. India is a vast country and it has hostile neighbors. Therefore, it needs appropriate armed forces to defend itself against its enemies. Answer the following questions. Our armed forces consist of three main forces. What are their names? Answer is Indian Army, Indian Navy, and Indian Air Force. Next. The Indian Armed Forces are military forces of the Republic of India. Additionally, the Indian Armed Forces are supported by the Indian Coast Guard and paramilitary organization and various inter-service commands and institutions such as Strategic Forces Command, the Andaman and Nicobar Command, and the Integrated Defense Staff. Next question. What are the heads of these forces are called? Answer. General, Admiral, and Air Chief Marshal. General Major Mukund Naravane is the Chief of the Army Staff. Admiral Karambir Singh is the Chief of Naval Staff. And Air Chief Marshal Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhadauria is the Chief of the Air Staff. The Indian Armed Forces are split into different groups based on their region of operation. Next question. Do you know who is the supreme commander of these forces? Answer is the President of India. The President of India serves as formal supreme commander of the Indian Armed Forces, while actual control lies with the executive headed by the Prime Minister of India. Next question. What is the junior most rank in the army? Answer is a lieutenant. A lieutenant is junior most commissioned officer in the armed forces, fire services, police, and other organization of many nations. The meaning of lieutenant differs in different military, but is often subdivided into senior and junior ranks. Next question. Where is the Indian Military Academy located? Answer is Dehradun. The Indian Military Academy is an officer training academy of the Indian Army in Dehradun, Uttarakhand. It was established in 1932 following a recommendation by a military committee set up under the chairmanship of Field Marshal Philip Chetwode. Next question. Where is the National Defense Academy located? Answer is Khadakwasla, Pune. The National Defense Academy is the Joint Services Academy of the Indian Armed Forces. where cadets of the three services, the army, the navy and the air force, train together before they go on to respective service academy for further pre-commissioned training. It is the first tri-service academy in the world. Next question. Where is the National Defence College located? Answer is New Delhi. National Defence College is the highest seat of strategic learning for officers of the Indian Armed Forces and the Civil Services of India. This is a very prestigious course attended only by a few handpicked defence officers of one star rank and civil servants of the rank of Joint Secretary to the Government of India. Next question. On which day is the Army Day located? Answer is 15 January. Army Day is celebrated on 15 January every year in India in recognition of Field Marshal Kodandra M. Kariyappa's taking over as the first Commander-in-Chief of the Indian Army from General Sir Francis Butcher, the last British Commander-in-Chief of India, on 15 January 1949. The day is celebrated in the form of parades and other military shows in the national capital, New Delhi, as well as in all headquarters. Next question. Which is the first short-range ballistic missile that was first test fired from Sriharikota? Answer is Prithvi missile. Prithvi is tactical surface-to-surface short-range ballistic missile developed by Defence Research and Development Organisation of India under the Integrated Guided Missile Development Programme. It is deployed by India Strategic Forces Command. According to expert, it is a clone of Soviet Union's Scud missile. Next question. Where is the Rashtriya Indian Military College located? Answer is Dehradun. The Rashtriya Indian Military College is a military school for boys situated in Dun Valley, Dehradun in India. The RIMC is a feeder institution for the National Defence Academy, Indian Naval Academy and subsequently the Indian Armed Forces. Fun fact, the first Indian Commander-in-Chief was General K.M. Kariyappa. Now students, we will meet our next session. Till then, goodbye. Have a nice day.